big wins. Yes, thank you, Fern. Congratulations. You told me, thanks guys, thank you. It's the official weigh-in last night at the Dorset Gardens. Oh yeah, well they told me he knocked his opponent out in two rounds. But in fact, you did it in the first round. Congratulations.
I'm very grateful and I'm happy, and today is one of my happiest days because I've looked toward the fight, because we're fighting diamonds. We find a lot of us are in Australia. But when I saw the fight, I know it will be an easy fight for me. That's why I told you in the way, I said I'll give it to for a second round. But when I saw the fight, it's a cheap fight. I need to stop, I'm going for to have my tea.
Easy fight. Do you like Australia?
I love Australia. If I didn't love Australia, I would have left since. But I love Australia. I wish to become an Australian citizen. You know, for me to start my career here and everything will go fine.
See you in the new year. Thank you, Ole. Come over, Murray. Congratulations on another big year. Ladies and gentlemen, our junior promoter, Murray Thompson. 43 big shows, Murray, and 5 this year. Congratulations.
Thanks, Howard.
Well, you've had your ups and downs, Murray, but he looks a hot prospect.
Yeah, I think with having him, Wally and Heath Ellis on the same bill, I think we've got the hottest property going around.
Murray, a lot of people to thank over a big year again, 2007.
Yeah, we had 6 promotions this year, 5 here and 1 up in Trelgan. And I just want to thank everyone who just keeps on supporting us, keeps on buying tables. We've got a good crowd, good walk-up, a lot of general admissions tonight. Just thanks for supporting boxing.
Thank you, Murray. Murray Thompson, Fighters Factory, another giant year. Ladies and gentlemen, our best boxer on the program undercard, Steve the Atom Attard. Steve Attard, come on down, Steve. Undercard fighter, Steve Attard. Congratulations, Steve. Steve, a big win, your first pro win, and then a magnificent trophy. Congratulations.
Yeah, thanks. It's good. It's good. It's
is it heavy? Okay, well done, Steve.
Thank you.
Steve Attard, a big win here tonight. First pro win and our best undercard fighter.
For the welcome to Melbourne for the first time, Junmar, Dulog, ranked number 7 in Australia in the world of boxing. From Liverpool.
62.3.
Unbeaten, 7 out of 7 8 match. Dual champion, Heath Ellis, against Junmar Dulong.
63.5.
Beautifully done.
Spot on.
How about that?
Heath, it was a very nice day at the Class and Prison Boxers and a very nice presentation. You must have felt pretty good about that.
Yeah, no, I was very honoured to get that award. It's a very prestigious award. I've got a good boxer, a good one, Michael Lester, and for me to get that, it's a real honour.
You spoke very well, particularly, and of course, you're many a man who's, as your dad, Neil, tells me, he's only had 4 wins, but he's 4 of the best fighters in Australia.
Yeah, I watched his last fight. Yeah. Boxer fought Lester Stella, and Lester, a very good boxer, and he gave him a pretty good fight until he got caught on the chin. It'll be a tough fight, and hopefully I'll come out on a great show.
Well, yeah, that's right. I mean, he comes forward, and he's a southpaw, I think, isn't he? So you're in good shape, and you're coming down, you're finding you like all the weight, natural weight. You know, you have to take on a few kilos in less food.
Yeah, you've got to cut my floors. a lot of diet, but yeah. I feel fit and strong and lose this weight, so I'm going to stay a lot longer.
Good luck, Heath. Heath the Head Ellis in the main event.
is us. Now they will know why they are afraid of the dark. Now they will learn why they fear the night.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you be please up standing for the Australian National Anthem. Could I have absolute quiet, please? Have your indulgence. Ladies and gentlemen, boxing lost another one of its great disciples in the last 10 days. A man who came from Ghana, Africa, and became a great featherweight, bantamweight and lightweight in Australia. He died at 72 years of age. He fought Gilberto Biondi for the Australian Lightweight Championship. Malcolm Bulner remembers this man, as does Gus Mercurio. Tonight we say, may God rest the soul of Ghana and Australian fighter Kimpo Archibald Kimpo Amafio. We have the traditional 10 gongs from our timekeeper, Damien Membry. Thank you, Damien. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Murray Thompson Fighters Factory, thank you for a great year of boxing. Welcome back to our main event, final show 2007. 8x3 minutes international super lightweights. Introducing on my left, occupying the red corner from Surigao City in the Philippines. Now he's a taxi driver, living in Liverpool, Sydney, New South Wales. 19 years of age, Dino Baholi's coach. He's had 14 professional fights, only 4 wins, 1 draw, 2 inside the distance. But don't be fooled, because he's fought the best fighters absolutely in Australia, including Lance Costello, Billy Dibb, Leonardo Zappavina, Alan Luxford, and Willie Kicken, arguably the best fighters in Australia. At 62.30 kilograms, blue trunks with a touch of white. Would you welcome Junmar Dulong. Junmar Dulong. And across the ring in the blue corner, Greg Grogan and all the team, Reservoir Gymnasium from Greenvale. 2 weeks ago, he was voted by the Victorian Past and Present Boxers Association as the best young fighter of 2007. Ladies and gentlemen, 7 professional fights, 7 wins, 4 inside the distance, ranked in world of boxing, number 4 in Australia. He's a dual Victorian champion at junior welterweight and welterweight. 63.50 kilograms. He's on fire. Heath, the Heat, Ellis. The Manila Thriller, Malcolm Boulder. Judges, Anita Williams, Alan McCall, Joe Mann. Timekeeper, name and memory, ringside physician, Dr. John Jury.
Welcome, centering gentlemen. Good clean fight. Obey my instructions all time. Shake hands now. Come on, fighting at the bell. Good luck.
Eight 3-minute rounds. Here we go. Round one. Okay, Heath. Heath, in the previous fights we've seen him, he's gone hell for leather, wanting to get out of there real quick. Let's see what he's doing in this one.
He's taking his time tonight.
Tonight already we can see a difference in him. He's taking his time. He was like a whirlwind the other fights he's in there with. Of course, he steamrolled Swan last time, James Swan, as he steamrolled most of his opponents, knocking out 4 of the 7 guys he's beaten. This guy might be a different kettle of fish here.
And he's southpaw, too.
Yeah, he's southpaw on top of it. So we'll see what's going to happen. Junmar Dulog, living in New South Wales, so he's getting the benefit of good
he's
Aussie diet.
He's a pretty fit-looking guy, too, and he's cocky.
Yes, he is.
He's only about 20 himself.
Yes, he's getting the benefit of Australian diet,
so
Australian
this
training.
Looks like the makings of a good fight.
Could very well be. In the fights that he's lost, the 9 he's lost, I don't know the exact number of KO losses, but he's fought all the best. All the best fighters in Australia he's fought.
He's certainly got a good idea.
Yeah, he knows what
he's
about.
Good jab by Keith.
Heath, beautiful jab. Actually, good right hand lead from Keith, too. A very good right hand lead. Not a good idea, but still an off. And again.
Oh, that was a beautiful.
He got hit. He's reddened his left eye. Dulog reddened Heath's left eye. Heath will have to be careful. Southpaw's got a hell of a punch in his right hand. The way it looks. And they must have got through to Keith, to Heath, because they said, settle down, mate, settle down. Watch your fighters, figure them out, watch what they're doing. Don't go crazy.
Yeah, he looks a bit at sea, doesn't he? Heath at the moment. Just trying to figure this southpaw out.
Yeah, he looks a bit awkward with him. Surely they'd had southpaw sparring with him, of course. Which, of course, is not always the same, naturally.
He's quite a comfortable southpaw. He doesn't look all that awkward.
No, he doesn't at all.
He looks comfortable with it. Pretty fit.
Very fit-looking boy, yeah. Heath is going to lead that.
He's pretty explosive himself.
Yeah.
Now this is the makings of a good fight.
All right, yes, this looks like it could be all right. I gave Heath the edge in that, even though he didn't do that much damage. He seemed to make the fight, made the other guy miss a fair bit, did land some punches, even though the other guy did too. But I felt Heath really contributed to making the fight, making that round a boxing round. So I gave him the round. Slim, but I gave him the round.
Yeah, it was slim and... The workload by both fighters was reasonable,
yeah.
Reasonably good, considering it was the opening round.
Second half, round two.
Junmar Dulog from the red corner and the blue trunks, now living in New South Wales, driving a cab up there. He's being trained in New South Wales and looks like he's being fed very well and being conditioned very well against Heath Ellis, the Heat.
And he's got a really good idea about what he's doing, you know, and Heath has got his work cut out here, I think.
Yes, he has. Yes, he has. I think he's a little bit at sea, as you said earlier, with the southpaw in there.
And this kid from New South has got a lot of confidence, hasn't he?
Yes, he's not overawed by Heath at all.
It's a big left hand.
Of course, he's been in with some top fighters, so he's been in with people as good as Heath, if not better. So what the hell, you know?
And he's taking the fight to Heath.
Yeah.
Something that's taken me by surprise.
He's really not awed by him at all. In fact, he's switching the fight around a little bit. In the first round, this is what Heath was doing. He was taking the fight up, and now the Junmar is taking the fight up to Heath.
Yeah, well, now we know why Heath's undoubtedly done his homework, and that's why he hasn't come out a bull at a gate. He's got a bit of respect for this kid.
Oh, wow.
That was a thunderous exchange.
Got to be careful of those southpaws. That's why I got the right hand out there, because they can hit with it.
You know, he's very explosive, but he's also relaxed. He's got a combination of being relaxed by the same token. And when he launches, he lets him go.
I think Heath at the moment is letting him go from too far away.
I think what Heath's doing is brilliant. I think he's the other guy is putting a lot of pressure on himself. And I think Heath's just pacing himself, and I think he's fighting the perfect fight. He's fighting a brilliant fight, actually. He's not getting suckered into standing toe-to-toe. He's just moving around and boxing and picking his punches and that.
I wonder how much work... Those are good punches. Those are good punches. Those are good power punches. That wins Heath the round right there. Good power punches that landed. He hurt Dulog.
He's pacing himself really well, Heath.
They really got to him because they slowed him right down. Now maybe the southpaw slowed him right down. But that's it. That was
very good round for both fighters.
Yes, well, Heath has edged it out. Edged it out with a brilliant power punches they landed there. He got him going. Not a bad sort of fight. This is going to be interesting. Heath should know now where he is at with this guy. He's had two rounds with him. He's won both rounds on my card. Just edged him out.
I think the other boy's work rates he's going a bit too hard. And I think Heath's doing the right thing. He's pacing himself. He's letting him go. And I think... as the fight peters goes forward, the guy from Sydney, he'll slow up a bit.
Could very well be.
I think he's fought a very professional fight, Heath.
Here we go. Round three in this eight-round fight. 5 rounds to go, 3 minutes a round. 15 minutes. 5 threes to go. Heath, I'm sorry, that's 6 threes to go. The third round coming up. Third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and eighth. 6 rounds to go.
Junmar sweating profusely, but he's full of energy, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. He's
he's like the junkyard dog.
Good jab by Heath. Now that's good, Heath. Keep that going. Get the momentum back on your side now. I think the fire is going to be lit here shortly.
The fire?
Yep, I think so. The heat is going to turn it up.
There he's paced himself really well. He's really professional for his young years. You know, he's not being overawed, he's just pacing himself. And Junmar has went a little bit hard, and I think it'll take its toll in the end.
Missing every one of those. That's got to take it out of you. Hitting and missing. Throwing punches and missing them takes out more than when you throw a punch and hit and land. Because when you miss, you got to bring it back all that way, too. It expends energy. But, see how fit. Oh, good right hand. Hit him right in that chin. And Junmar really got hit and tagged with that, but came back pretty strong.
It didn't faze him.
No, it didn't. He came right back.
This is the makings of a good fight.
Ooh.
Junmar's got a good idea that he's going to be around for the end of the fight.
Well, like I said, I don't know his losses by stoppages, but he's been in with some very good guys. So he's not overawed by this youngster. 19-year-old youngster with 7 wins to his credit. He's still reaching too far with his punches.
He's only 20 himself, Gus.
Yeah. Yep, both youngsters in there.
Oh, that was a big left hand if it had a connected.
Yep.
By Junmar.
Hey.
It's a very good fight.
That's a hard round to score, I'll tell you the truth.
Pretty evenly matched fighters up to date.
Very much so. Very, very much so. Very much so. That was quite a decent, even round, I felt. They were very closely matched, very closely put together on that. Junmar trying very hard. He's getting a bit more closer, getting a little closer, getting a little more discipline too. He's hitting a bit better.
He is.
But I expect him to explode here, though. I expect the heat to light up in a moment.
I know the other guy, Junmar, doesn't look like slowing up just yet. I think he might, but not just yet.
Round four in this 8x3-minute round fight with Heath Ellis in the black trunks coming out of the blue corner.
I don't think anyone told him how good Junmar, how good Heath is.
Yeah,
he's not phased.
Not overawed. Junmar Dulog in the blue trunks out of the red corner. Ooh, a beautiful, beautiful punch in the pit of the stomach. Those are important. We'll see now how he weathers that kind of a storm.
It's giving him a little bit extra to think about.
Yes, he certainly is. And he seems a little bit more purposeful to me. And he hasn't done any showboating either, which I'm glad about. They must have got very strong on that with him, too. Boxing is too important. It's too dangerous in there to showboat.
Especially with this opponent.
Yeah. Oh, good right hand from Dulog.
Junmar hasn't come here to survive, that's for sure.
No, he's come here to win.
And he's cocky, too.
Yeah. Oh, beautiful right hand. Stuck right in there. Heath landed a nice right hand. He's just edging the point score his way. It's a little unusual to see Heath this control. Oh, beautiful right hand again.
Beautiful right hand.
Now that might take a bit of steam out of Junmar. Might get a little
with
bit...
Well, that body punch before, that sort of slowed him up, didn't it? And the pace he set sort of might be starting to take its toll a little bit.
Yeah. Starting to swing like a rusty gate there. Your jab works well, Heath. Use your jab, mate. Keep to the basics. Keep the jab up. Keep the left hand up there and jab with it. Junmar's got both his hands up there.
Junmar's waiting to counter.
Waiting to counter, yeah.
And it's making Heath a little bit hesitant.
I think he felt a little bit of Junmar's power earlier, too. Whereas Junmar has felt Heath's power. I think that's affected him a little bit, to tell you the truth.
Well, second thought, now he sort of looks. He's coming again, Junmar. This is amazing. He's of a brilliant
fight. Not a bad fight. Not a bad fight at all.
You could watch these two guys fight every day of the week, couldn't you?
Yeah. Okay, we're getting into the fifth round, is it? One, two, three, four rounds finished. Fifth round coming up.
Seconds out, round five.
That's it, fifth round. I've got Heath Ellis slightly ahead on my unofficial scorecard.
I've got a strong feeling, Gus, these two guys will have a few more fights before they retire against each other.
Yes, it looks like they're pretty well evenly matched anyway.
Oh, yeah.
He's beat him to the punch on that one, that left hook.
I don't think there's much in this on class.
I've got just the shade Heath's way, to tell you the truth.
Now, when I mean on
class,
I think they're both pretty evenly matched.
Match, yeah, you're right, they are. I can't understand.
And
how
he's got as much chance of being world class as Heath has. I think they're two very good fighters, Gus.
Well, this guy might have got all his losses earlier in the piece when he wasn't under proper nutritional care, under proper training, and before he moved to New South Wales. He could have had some losses that he didn't deserve. He fought some big timers here. He might have got juiced out of a couple of those fights that he won. He should have won. Didn't get the decision, which we saw tonight happen, which is disgraceful. I mean, what's fair is fair.
I can't split them. They're pretty even.
Well, as
they're pretty
said,
even in class.
As I said, I got a shade to Heath.
Gee. I tell you what, Junmar's work rate's phenomenal.
Yes, he's going very strong. He's low. Every punch has got something going on it too.
Yeah. It's quite amazing work rate. Against Heath, and Heath's no slouch by any means.
No.
This is a brilliant fight. And it's going to do a hell of a lot for Heath's confidence too. You know, for the future.
Yeah.
He's handling it all right so far.
Yeah.
But Heath knows, he definitely knows he's in a fight.
Very difficult this round too. Very difficult. Oh, wow.
I tell you what, he's gonna have to go to the bottom of the barrel to get this one. Because he's gonna have to earn this fight.
Yes, he's gonna have to dig deep, reach down deep inside of him. Because this guy's not gonna let him get away with it. Junmar Dulog is doing, he's keeping Heath honest.
We're keeping him honest. It's a brilliant fighter. He's going really well, you know. He's pacing himself really well. He throws a mad swing in every now and then.
Yeah.
But in all, he's kept his composure.
That mad swing every once in a while just bothers me a bit.
But now I see why he's got respect for Junmar, why he started off slow.
Yeah,
he knows what he's in against. He knows this guy can fight.
Yeah, and besides that, he was kind of holding back, trying to suss out his southpaw stance, too.
Yeah, had to work that one out.
Oh, that was a left-handed jab. A right uppercut and a left hook.
Yeah, it was beautiful.
Now, if he keeps Junmar off of him for the rest of this, those punches enough to win the round for him.
Where does Junmar get this energy? He's incredible, his workload.
I'd like them to straighten out his punches a bit more. Work on straightening his punches out.
Heath might be letting this slip away from him.
Well, he's marginally ahead on my card at this
point. Yeah, but the Junmar's keeping the work rate up. And Heath's not going with him.
Yeah, they got to straighten his punches up. He's getting too many of those wild swings, which are not doing that much good. Now, he's hanging on there, letting the other guy do some work there. He shouldn't do that.
He's got to keep his work rate up, Heath. Otherwise, he could be in trouble, mate.
He is slowing down. He's not doing as much as he did earlier in this round. In fact, he has slowed down a fair bit. I didn't see any particular punch that might have slowed him down, did you?
I'm amazed because I thought he'd slow the other guy down. Junmar copped a few good punches, but it hasn't fazed him. He keeps coming up, and he's putting the pressure on Heath.
Yeah. Now he's hanging on like mad the last couple of times. Hey, you see that breathing?
He took a deep breath then. He's huffing.
He's out of shape. He was out of shape one other time. They said he had the flu or sickness or something. Maybe having a trouble with his conditioning. See, he's not trying to do anything in there. He's already conserving energy.
Junmar's confidence is building too. He's for real.
Look at that. You see, that's good stuff.
Good body punching.
And that's all point scoring.
This is one great fight, Gus. One great fight.
Oh, there we go.
Well, we've got a surprise package here, haven't we?
I got
we,
one
Gus?
Point in for Heath.
Heath's in front, but
1 point I got.
It's pretty, pretty level. It's pretty level, yeah. Isn't it? Whatever lady had he, it's, I gave that round to Junmar.
I did too. Yes, I did too. I did too, that brought him up to one, Junmar 1 point behind. So, I mean, there's two rounds to go. I must be...